Next week, Israeli citizens are heading to the ballots to vote on which parties will represent them in the Knesset, Israel's parliament. On its own, that's not unusual. What is unusual, and in fact has never happened before, is that they're voting for the second time this year. To understand how Israel even got into this situation, we need to go back almost a year, to November 2018. That was when Avigdor Lieberman, who was defense minister at the time, resigned his position, and his party called Yisrael Beiteinu, Hebrew for Israel Our Home, left the ruling coalition of parties in the Knesset. Lieberman and his party did this because they disagreed with how the Israeli government responded to terror coming from the Gaza Strip. Problem was, that left Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu with only a very narrow majority. So narrow, the government couldn't even continue passing laws. When Netanyahu failed to get another party to join his coalition, the Knesset dissolved itself on December 26, 2018, in favor of starting over with new general elections. Usually, calling for new elections would be enough to fix the problem, but this time, that wasn't the end of the story. The Knesset is made up of 120 members, elected in what's known as a national proportional election. Basically, there are a bunch of political parties, and you vote for the one you want to represent you. Then, the seats in the Knesset are divided up among the parties, based on the percentage of votes they got. But that's not enough to form a government, because there are so many parties that usually, even the largest one doesn't get a majority of seats. The current record is 56. So you need a coalition, a group of several parties that together have a majority of at least 61 Knesset seats. This is where the president, whose role in Israeli politics is otherwise pretty ceremonious, comes into the process. The president consults the party leaders and determines who will most likely be able to form a viable government, usually the head of the party that won the most seats. That person has 28 days to get other parties to agree to a coalition. If successful, they become prime minister. If they don't, the president designates someone else to try to form a coalition. The elections were held on April 9, 2019. And the Israeli public voted 11 parties into the Knesset.
אלה תוצאות האמת של בחירות 2019. מפלגת השלטון, הליכוד, עם 35 מנדטים, למספר זהה זוכה גם כחול לבן בראשות בני גנץ, מפלגה גדולה, אבל בלי יכולת להרכיב ממשלה.
After the election, President Reuven Rivlin consulted with the elected parties to get their recommendation for prime minister. Based on their input, he assigned the task of forming the coalition to Netanyahu. The right-wing and religious parties usually work well together, and in total they earned 65 seats, which should have made forming a coalition a piece of cake. But five of those seats were held by Lieberman and his party. Netanyahu started his negotiations, but quickly hit a brick wall. This is Ilon Levy, a journalist and a news anchor for I-24 News.
The coalition that has governed Israel has been a coalition between the right-wing nationalists and the religious parties. But what happened after the last election was that coalition broke down. The secular nationalist Yisrael Beiteinu party demanded a law for very modest conscription of ultra-Orthodox men into the army. That was a red line for Netanyahu's ultra-Orthodox partners. As a result, the talks broke down, and Netanyahu was unable to form a government.
At the same time, his option to join forces with Blue and White and form a coalition with them didn't pan out, since they wouldn't join a government headed by Netanyahu due to ongoing investigations into three cases of alleged corruption.
Israel's attorney general said today he intends to indict Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu for corruption.
You can check out the links below for a more in-depth look at the allegations. With the deadline approaching, Netanyahu asked for and was granted a two-week extension to try to form a coalition, but still no progress was made. On May 29, 2019, at 11:55 p.m., minutes before Netanyahu's extension would expire, which is when the president would start the process of tasking someone else with the responsibility of forming a coalition, the Knesset passed an unprecedented bill, pushed through by a member of Netanyahu's Likud party and supported by 8 of the 11 parties.
Benjamin Netanyahu.
The bill dissolved the newly elected parliament, triggering another election and making it the shortest serving parliament in Israel's history.
Political turmoil has erupted in Israel, where the country will hold an unprecedented second election.
This move made it impossible for the president to choose someone else to form a coalition. Instead, it started the whole election process over again. Everybody blamed everybody else for causing Israel to have its second elections in 6 months. Parties on the right, headed by the Likud, blamed Lieberman and his party. Netanyahu claimed that, quote, the public chose him, and Lieberman joined the ranks of the left, ruining the coalition. Lieberman, for his part, said he was just standing by his principles. Meanwhile, the Blue and White party, along with parties on the left, claimed the call for elections came from Netanyahu's need to stay in power, to try to avoid having to face his legal troubles. So what happens now?
There are only a handful of logical scenarios after next week's election, and none of them look realistic at all. Netanyahu's right-wing coalition without Yisrael Beitenu might manage to get 61 members of Knesset, a majority, and then there's no need for Avigdor Lieberman. It's possible that parts of Blue and White might agree to join a Netanyahu government despite the impending corruption charges. That's also something they've promised they won't do. But it's possible that members of the Likud might get rid of Netanyahu or agree to nominate someone else or agree to join an opposition-led government, although that looks extremely unlikely at the moment. Or the other option is we go to a third set of elections this year.
That last option has been dubbed by some as a constitutional crisis, since Netanyahu will remain prime minister of the transitional government, a continuation of the previous government that can't pass any major legislation, leaving Israel without a functioning government for over a year, headed by an unelected person running the government, since Netanyahu's previous term is up. And even if Netanyahu succeeds in forming a government, there is no promise that the criminal charges circling above his head won't shuffle the cards again. This isn't to mention the immense costs, estimated to be $500 million in direct costs alone, with money that was meant to be spent on infrastructure, welfare, and healthcare going towards holding another election. Based on many public opinion polls, a unity government, when parties of opposing political ideologies join forces for the greater good, seems to be the preferred option of many in Israel.
Unity is a nice word, and polls show that most Israelis want a unity government. The only question is, who heads it? Another poll showed most Israelis were against a unity government headed by Netanyahu. The opposition Blue and White Party says it wants a unity government. Yisrael Beitenu says it wants a unity government. But Blue and White has also been clear it won't sit in a government led by Benjamin Netanyahu, leading to the question of who can lead that government. And that's why these elections are really about whether Netanyahu can continue serving as prime minister, or whether his time is up and it's time for someone else to reach across the aisle and be able to form that government.
While people like to joke, vote early and vote often, let's hope Israelis don't take that too seriously.